Hello, my name is Abe. Welcome back to Enter the Gungeon as the Paradox. I got a little bit of a deep voice today. I have no idea why. Is that a good thing? Is that a bad thing? I don't know. Maybe I'm just sounding a little bit tired. I'm not actually that tired. We got the dog. Aw, crap. Where's 0020? His prediction has come true. I'm petting the dog. We got the Tommy. We got the budget revolver. And we got a dog. Let's do it. It's his perfect run. His ultimate start here. We're a gangster with a dog! Yeah, see? You're never gonna take me alive, mage! Someone needs to at him. Get him over here. Pound Hades says sell the dog. What if we sold the dog before AB got here, and then when he asked what our starting item was, we said definitely not the dog. Definitely didn't just sell the dog. Yeah, see? I like the Tommy gun. The Tommy gun is a good starting gun. It's solid. It's decent. It'll get you out of a jam. Always reliable. It's got the makings of a good run, I hope. And what is this? This is like the convict alternate starting gun. I never take the alternate convict starting items, like the starting skin, the starting gun. I don't know why, but just like personally, I like the defaults. I like that you've got the jumpsuit as opposed to the punk rocker outfit. I like just having you damn dirty dog. How dare you give me armor? I like all the default stuff, so I never use this weird bean gun that just fires like weird beans. It's just like very strange. I'll be honest with you, this is probably like a reference to something. Like maybe this is a reference to like, Abe's Odd World, and like this is the Abe Odd World pistol or something. I don't know, because I've never played Abe's Odd World, but it's probably like a reference to something that I don't understand myself. It's not like an alien zapper gun, because then it would go pew 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 when you shoot it. So it's not that, but I don't know what it is. All right. Turns out I'm glad I didn't think about buying that bomb. Definitely did not think about buying the bomb. This is a great start to a run. Wait over a cell creep until he gets here and then sell the dog the second he says anything in chat. That would take way too long and I'd have to do a lot of editing in order to cut that out of the YouTube video. I'll just be like, we're not gonna wait. I'm not gonna make you wait for this payoff. Although that would be funny. I would totally do it. You know what? You guys can get sucked. Into hell! Don't lie, we all know you won't edit shit. I did editing the other day to put 0020's intro into the video, so obviously I can do some editing. The question is whether I remember to do it, which is almost always a no. If it requires any amount of effort or like watching my own video in order to find what I needed to edit, I'm probably just gonna skip it. It's slightly laziness, but also just like, I don't forget where it is, and I've got like, 7 hours of video to go through every single day. I can't just watch it all. That'd be way too long. You out there, on the other hand, you can watch it all. There's gotta be time for that in your daily, day-to-day life, right? Messy. Gonna have to use a blank there. Was a little out of position going around the fire, but I guess that's kind of the intention of it, isn't it? There you go, that's what we're looking for. Really? Like, you're gonna give me a frickin' wandstone? Now this is an interesting one. Healing every floor or bracket key. I don't know if you're going to like or love this choice, but we're taking the bracket key. I would much, much rather kill enemies faster than heal. Wow, I have enough money for this. I had one credit remaining for the cat claw, which synergizes with something. Yo, this is great. Spartan loadout. It looks like a faster shot. Maybe it has like some weird homing and piercing characteristics to it. This seems lovely. We also get coin crown early. So it's gonna be one of those runs of Gungeon. I'll take it. I'll freaking take it, man. We done? We done. Let's get out of here. Too good for healing? Well, I mean, to an extent, yeah. But like if the healing charges were maintained over, you know, floor after floor, if you could stock them up, it'd be different, but it is piercing. But I really don't want to take healing if we ever, you know, never end up needing it. I would much rather take healing if it was like, oh, there's a vampire on this floor and then I can get some value out of it or something. Or I've got cigarettes and two active item capacity and then we can hold on to it. Yeah, this seems absolutely lovely and wonderful. And we have a lodestone amulet. And also the infinite money coin crown. Dude, cat claw? That's a good gun. And the dog paid out with another freaking key. Good lord. If you get remote bullets, this run would be omega cool. It also, it already is omega cool. What are you talking about? I have a weird homing, piercing, cat claw explosive gun. A Tommy gun. A dog who's actually paying out with items. Like three synergies already. Hate to break it to you, the run's looking pretty dope. I love the super maximum homing on this. I know I could use the bracket key. I really should, honestly. But maybe we'll use it on this room? Nah, maybe not this room. Lespoff says, the dog is OP, I'm yelling you. Why are you yelling at me? Hey, 0020, welcome, how's it going? Don't look at the screen. Coin crown. This, the bulletkin thinks too heavy, okay. This is not the bulletkin think that I am their god. It is too heavy, and I don't know what that means. Is it like double money drops or something? Double chance of getting money from room rewards? I don't know. Dude, we're getting so many ammo drops. What is going on with this run? This is absurdly good luck. I love it. Whoops. The only thing I need now is just to wanna see if I can make the drop, make the gap. The only thing I need to do now is just like actually get money with the coin crown. And like bomber gun, and then we can just buy everything we want from every floor. It's fantastic. All right, I guess we're done. Do we have enough money for it? We do. So I tell you what, we're gonna fight Blobulord with this, which will give us the money for the lead gun, the lead amulet. Well, the lodestone amulet, really. And then from there, we'll just have like an extra surplus of cash. Could you switch to coin crown at the end of the room and you gotta use it for the whole duration, asks for Dacula. Honestly, dude, I don't even know what the synergy is. What is too heavy? If the synergy is, if you're holding the gun, you get double room rewards or something, then yeah, you could probably do it by just holding onto the gun when the room clears. But again, I don't even know what the frickin' synergy is. What is too heavy? TWO heavy. Foodbreaker asks 0020 if they own a dog, who says no. I've had a couple of dogs. My parents did anyways, but I don't have any pets right now. Ah! I don't care about taking damage. Yeah, we'll lose the no-hit. Who gives a hoot? Because we're gonna have so much money at the end of this floor. If the player has coin crown, the chance for coin crown to spawn money is doubled. So it should just always be active, I think. Which is nice, you know, more money. More money, more problems. Oh, bad timing on my bomb. So we should have like $100 at the end of this, and we'll get that lodestone amulet. All right. Do you count the pits for no hit? I mean, personally, usually I don't. However, it doesn't matter on this run because you've already taken damage. All right, so now we have $400. We'll buy this, I mean, we have two keys. We could do this. Open up just like another chest. Kind of the opinion, why not? It's Rolling Eye, huh? It's not horrible. I've grown to like Rolling Eye to a small extent because it does sort of protect you a little bit from damage you might otherwise take, but it's not a great item. Not in any sense of the word. Rat? I don't know if I'll do the rat because I don't really care about the rat, but... Lonely Stroll, welcome. Pet the dog. I have been. When the dog pays out with an item, we pet the dog. That is the rule of cool. So I kind of like this modus operandi here, which is that we're going to be using both Little Bomber, because it's actually a pretty good gun, and we're going to be using the Cat Claw as well. Cat Claw for most... You know, room clearing, and the explosive gun just for like opening up. For large rooms like this, I think we can just, you know, get away with, you know, doing most of that, and then some of this, and then they're all dead. And ammo, we'll take for this. I think I got a lot of money from that for some reason. All right, and we can also take like meat bun, that's good too. Unfortunately, it doesn't really do anything for the Cat Claw, because the explosions don't get increased damage. But the blunt force trauma of the bomb will do better. Technically, the needles will do slightly more damage, but it's like very minimal. This is really more of a like Tommy gun buff. Yeah, see. Dog deserves more pets. Dog will get the pets when he gives me items. That's the deal. That's the unspoken bond that I've spoken speakingly. You know what? I think you're actually better off with a Tommy gun. Anything that kills you faster. Well, that one's okay. It is what it is. It is what it is. Was there a key in the shop? Of course there was a key in the shop. What kind of dumbass question was that, Abe? Why did I not go buy the key? I guess for some reason I skipped the shop and I just thought to myself, we haven't been to the shop yet. Might as well blow up this chest that you're not going to be able to open. Forgetting that we have, in fact, have seen the shop. Nice meat bun. Meat bun would be a shame if he got hit and lost it together with the crest, says Verdacula. Oh, ye of little faith. Okay, these are going to be very fast needles. I love it. And very fast Tommy shots. I love it. I wonder if the, I wonder if the speed up on the needles makes them more likely to home through enemies, hitting other enemies behind them. That's a very dangerous room. All right, there you go. There's a guy's pet. Take full advantage of this moment. That's all you're gonna get. Ada Alex, welcome. How are you doing? Welcome to the stream. Excuse me. Cough, cough. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think I'll get the gold amulet. Yeah, I think I'll get the Elder Blank here. Okay, interesting. Got a couple of guns there. Yeah, just give me the Elder Blank. We've got blank synergies now. The bracket key's fun, but now I can press spacebar and kill everything with a blank. And, you know, have something that's a little bit better on boss fights. Why the heck not? Why not? Why the heck not? We do a lot of damage now with our Tommy. Boss killing extraordinaire. Oh, hey, ammo synthesizer. That seems pretty good. Which synergizes with, wait, does it synergize with something? No, it doesn't. I thought it did. It was actually the HP upgrade synergizing with the Chief Master, which sucks anyways. That's fine. We'll deal with it. We'll deal. All right, let's get the heck out of here. You know, I'll buy those. I could actually go for a little bit more cash. I've been able to spend money non-stop lately. We're gonna need some more money to buy stuff on this floor, I think. Oh, give me a second. Careful, dog, careful! You're gonna get squished! Dude. That was a great room for that gun, huh? Just kind of clear out the room and then, you know, toss some bombs in there. That's what the bombs are for, getting money. I love these fast bombs. A lot of golden bomber synergies lately. You know, I feel like it's a rather common synergy, admittedly. I do see it relatively frequently. I don't know if I see it like super frequently or anything like that. But I enjoy it whenever it shows up. Golden bomber is a fantastic synergy. You can never convince me otherwise. It is beautiful. It is a beautiful butterfly in a sea of crap synergies. I'm looking at you, elephant gun. I mean, honestly, I might as well just, like, keep killing things. You know, like, keep chunking through the little bomber ammo here, getting some kills, getting some money. Little Bomber and Queen Gungeon Ant have multiple ways of getting the synergies. Queen Gungeon Ant is a synergy I get substantially less often, but it is also a pretty good synergy. Yes. Yeah, Queen Gungeon Ant's a lot of fun. I like having a... It's a lot of fun because it makes it actually a good item. Because normally that synergy blows. Or I should say that gun blows, the Gungeon Ant. But the Queen Gungeon Ant's really good, so I like getting the synergy there. You know, it's a lot of fun to turn it into a rocket launcher.
Rocket launcher!
I also really like this tight spread crown of guns here. I kind of like that it's not, you know, targeted directly on my cursor. I can sort of have a little bit of crowd control with it. It's a good gun right now. Sure, why not? We've got so much money. You know what? I don't know why I spent all those shots on you. It was completely unnecessary. Drop the dog. Do not pet the dog. Pet the dog. If Mud was here, I would ask him to create a poll. And whoever won the poll, that's what we would do. Latem, welcome. How's it going? And Mighty Odin, how you doing? And everyone out there who I may have also missed, how you guys doing? Hope everyone's having a great day. Other than my voice feeling a little bit deeper than usual, I'm having a pretty good day myself. All right. Well, don't blow up the gun, please. I guess we'll just keep exploring. I mean, we have 6 blanks, gold amulet, still have a little bomber, still have this crown of guns. It's all very good. Who's Latem? Latem. I don't know who they are. I don't know who anyone is in chat. I mean, it's kind of just like anonymity on the internet, right? By the way, here's more money, if we ever wanted some. Feeling like you didn't have enough cash on a run? Have a vampire! And get more money, honey. Oh, hey, for the price of 1 key, I can get some more stuff in here. Actually, I need to buy this key so I can access the chest after the boss fight. Don't forget about the frickin' chest, man. That's important. Right, let's, I don't know, Tommy? The accuracy upgrade is gonna make this real easy. At least until we run out of ammo in this gun. And then it'll still be, you know, easy-ish. Would certainly love more ammo for the Tommy, though. You know what, I'm just gonna, you know, probably abuse my blanks a little bit. This is not a very good gun. What about this? That's gotta be good damage, right? It looks like it's pretty good damage. Whoa. Rude. I guess we didn't need those blanks from the last floor, but you know. Always be prepared. Be prepared. Be prepared. We get the crescent crossbow, huh? The heck does this synergize with? Alas, Nyperion! Heck yeah! We've got a magical crown gun now on our heads. It's beautiful, beautiful! We also have a lot of HP to burn. It's beautiful! Math Jongkook, welcome. Is this a clone game? Nope. It's just a run, just a standard run. Ada Alex says, I've never seen the synergy. It's a pretty fun one. I don't get it that often. I like that we also have better accuracy. That's gonna make it quite nice. Where is it? Oh, there it is. It's hard to see, actually. It's a pretty decent run. We'll use this crown definitely for the next floor, and then we'll go from there, honestly. I feel like we also have like a rate of fire increase with this, but it might just be the normal rate of fire of the gun. Maybe that's a little bit of too heavy. Maybe it's also giving us a slight rate of fire increase. I don't know. It don't matter. We're out. Let's see how this works. I think sometimes it also fires like hexagon style shots, but I don't know how to make it do that. It might do it randomly, it might do it with like another synergy or something. Oh god, but it's doing a pretty good job. I'm pretty sure these shots also still have that homing characteristic. Maybe they don't though. Sounds beautiful. Yeah, I'll do this. I'll do a free room. We're gonna need ammo. You know, we have ammo. We have ammo synthesizer, don't we? Ah! Ammo shouldn't be that much of a problem. Okay, yes, we could have gotten a little bit lower on HP, but we have 600 bucks. We don't need cash, okay? Let's see, we have 2,200 ammo right now. And I guess that's just gonna go, you know, up and down on occasion. Hopefully more up than down, though. $2,261. Hey, you know what? That's a positive. Literally, we're in the positive now. We're in the black. We'll occasionally reload our crown. How does that work? I don't know. Okay, and these shots are definitely homing in. I just saw them really home in on that corpse after I killed the enemy, so... You know, if anything, we know that they home in on corpses. Good room for ammo refunding. Hey, 2113, we got some back. I also do notice that some of the bullets are big when they come out of this crown. I don't know if that makes them do more damage or if it's just a visual effect. But some of these are definitely big. What does that do for us? I don't know. You can just hold left click and clear rooms. Yeah, I just kind of like wave my hat around. My hat kills them. I am the king of the gungeon. All right, you know what? Just for you guys. He's stuck. Goodbye, pupper number two. See you never. See ya, goodbye. You're stuck in a wall. Oh no, there he is, he's back. I just had to look away. He's definitely the thing. He's definitely a horrible eldritch monstrosity, pretending to be a dog. Because otherwise, how would he have gotten free from that wall prison he was in? All right, you get the pet dog. There you go. A little bit of that. Thank you very much for the key. Oh, and you know what? Thank you very much for the key. We got a chest right there. Look at that. Look at that luck. Look at that luck. That luck right there. Look at that luck. Black hole gun, huh? I mean, that's very good. Might just like pick it up and then yeet it.
Yeet.
Compressed air tank. Yeah, sure. I mean, it's only $100. It's not that much. I do wish I had another key though now. All right, you know what? Fair enough, game. Fair enough. This is not the boss room. That's the boss room. Well. Actually, really don't want to use this gun because I think it's too strong. So what about, like, sharks? What about really fast sharks? Da-dun. 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 Want to go over here and pop this? Da-dun. Da-dun. Eat him! And a key. Lovely. Oh, and another mimic pedestal. That's pretty dope. Actually, I feel like the best thing for us here would be Cat Claw, because I can just shoot it around a corner like this. Oh, yeah, I mean, the shark could do it too. Thanks for stealing my shark thunder there. Da-dun. Da-dun. Dun 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 dun. Da 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 da. Reload up. You know? It's not bad. It's a pretty good reload speed there. Oh no, I'm accidentally petting the dog. Oh no! Cabbage Box is welcome. How's it going? You're late? You are late. 44 minutes late. How could you? How could you do this to me? How could you do this to your father and me? Ooh, a chest. Well, I'll come back when I actually have some freaking keys. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge, dog. You know what? Blow up. I'll take the ammo for this, I don't care. You know what? Don't shoot me. Don't run into me, don't touch me. Leave me alone. This is the wrong direction. Your father and I, grammar is important. You know what's not important? Grammar. I don't know why I dodge rolled. There's absolutely no reason for that in that room. I'm not always smart. Yeah. Freaking erased them, good lord. Mud, welcome, how's it going? You missed the start of a pretty good run, Mud. I hope you're having a good day too. Mud today was streaming a little bit of Risk of Rain 2, followed by Divinity maybe? I don't know. I don't know what you stream half the time. You were definitely streaming Risk of Rain though. I hope you had a good time with that muddy mud. Oh, Jesus. What the heck was that? You hear that sound? Was that like my G-chat trying to ping me a message again? I've been a bad friend. I've been ignoring my G-chat for quite a while. I probably have people who are trying to be like, hi, how's it going? Long time no see. And I'm just like, do-do-do-do-do. Not paying attention to G-chat. We need more keys, dude. We are running low on keys. You know, we do need more Guan stones. That'll help. It's gotta help, right? It's gotta help. It's gotta... Hey, you know, as long as there's no mimics, because maybe there's a chance we can actually get a couple of keys out of this. I mean, we got the dogs. We have the dogs necessary to make this happen. I keep hearing that drop sound effect, and I'm like, ooh, keys! No, it's just money. Oh, it's just even more money. There you go. Oh, the slidey dog. He's rubbing his butt on the ground. Ooh. Dude, I'll take a damage upgrade. I don't freaking care. Now we got a couple of bonus keys on the floor. Oh, hell yeah. Moonscraper, I'll take it. Let's also go to Mapman. I want a Mapman item as opposed to a blue chest item. Angry bullets, huh? Is that gonna be good with this? I don't think these shots pierce, so I think it would actually be pretty good. This is an interesting one, though. I don't know if it's actually gonna be good, but hopefully it is. Crown of Guns. Trying to think, what bosses could we fight and what is our item? Okay, if it's KP, we want this. If it's Wallmonger, we just want to shoot bullets. Oh God, I can't see anything. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So many damage numbers. None of them make any sense. The bitrate! No, not the bitrate! Got him. You need to pet both dogs in every drop? No, only one of the dogs is giving me items. Only one dog gets the pets, unfortunately, for you. Are we good? We have one key, but I'll be honest, I'd rather save this for the next floor. Like, yeah, we could get something out of this chest, but, you know, we could also get two chests next floor. And we got a key! Now, I don't know what to think, because, yeah, we got a bonus key out of that. However, if we didn't break the chest, we wouldn't have gotten the key. So we would be down to zero keys if we opened the chest. So it's like the worst of both worlds right there. Because I would certainly love to have the key before I broke the chest, but now we don't have the key. This is not the gun I wanted. Hold on. Ice you guys. I wanted this and this. There we go. They're next to each other even. That's beautiful. It was like 24 and 12. So I think the big shots do deal more damage. 17, 12, 17, 2, 17, 12, 12. It feels like the big crown shots are doing more damage actually, which is kind of nice. Now they're doing like 24 damage. I don't understand that at all. Oh, it's a mimic! Thank God I noticed. Just take the ammo. I don't think it really matters what gun we take it for. This is like the perfect room for this gun. No. I'll take your ammo. I mean, it's not like we're very cool on this run. I mean, we got two dogs, it's pretty cool. But, you know, something is definitely giving us extra ammo drops, it feels like. Bees, not the bees. Bees can very easily hurt me, and if the bees hurt me, then I'm gonna be very sad, please, because I'm gonna lose my, my meat bun. I don't want to lose my meat bun. It's delicious. Got him. And that's not even a dog key. I don't gotta pet anything. All right. Fruity Lucens, welcome, asks, Abe, are you a magical girl? I mean, I do have the crown. Do we have litchy eye bullets? Nope. Just a couple of synergies. Synergies and lots of bees. Unfortunately. Might as well keep exploring. Might as well lose the meat bun bonus right before we actually go and fight the dragon. That's how this is gonna end up, right? What does this synergize with? Reload roll. Makes sense. Let's buy the turkey. Kinda wish I had more turkeys though. Well, that's how I feel about that. Actually, we should still grab it. And then throw it away. Now, I'll take remote bullets, but I'm probably gonna drop them. There's some interesting possible synergies with this. Yes, it's gonna make the coin crown be ridiculous, and that's kinda cool, but I don't know if we really need it, because we have not perfect accuracy, but we have high damage, a spread shot, it kills a lot of enemies, and I don't have to aim it. Okay, that's pretty cool. So I don't know, we might not need this. What does this synergize with? I gotta look. Massive effect, who cares? But now that we have this, I'm like, okay, this actually is kinda cool. Now that we have, you know, giant stout bullets and everything, I'm pretty happy with this. Because it looks ridiculous. I'm kind of curious what else we have that could be like a cool remote bullet synergy here. And I don't think we have too much. Like, it's definitely this. And then, I mean, these shots will bounce. Yeah. The sharks will go where I'm pointing. No. Well, kinda here. These shots don't even have like any range to them. These are too fast anyways. I guess it is just crown of guns, huh? Oh, you see that little visual effect? That's water. That's what that is, it's called water. It's a W-A-T-A-R, water. But we do have very big, heavy damage dealing bullets. And you know what? They're bouncing. They're bouncing, so they're doing additional damage, more than you would think. I'm curious though. I mean, it's pretty sweet. Thanks to Turkey, we're getting a lot of ammo back on this too. Like, let's just stack up all of the needles and then blow them all up at once. You ready? They just disappeared. You're the most beautiful. Seath the Scaleless. We're Dark Souls now, boys. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful run. Thank you for all the items. Was there any ammo? There was. I'll buy it. All right. I think I'll actually go buy the op as well. Because we have the scope, which means that we can do the no scope. And with our other damage upgrades, we might be able to one-shot bosses. I haven't Actually, with double damage, we definitely can. So I didn't do that at all in the dragon fight, but maybe we can try to like one shot one phase of the lich or something, even though it would still be fun to use the Crown of Guns gun for that. ML Burke says, I started my first Dark Souls playthrough yesterday. Anyone out there playing Demon Souls? I am not, because I don't own a PlayStation 5. And also, I played it on the PlayStation 3, I think. No! It's fine. We technically took damage, but our blank activated because we have the blank item, which I took specifically for the situation. We're okay. Oh, thank God. Yeah, I, Is Demon Souls on PC? Did they release it as well as on PlayStation? I actually do not know. I didn't look it up at all because I had already played Demon Souls before, but I don't know. It's for PC, maybe I'll play it at some point. I'm aware, the thing is, you know, if we're talking chronologically, Demon's Souls came out before Dark Souls. After Dark Souls came out, came Dark Souls 2, and after Dark Souls 2 came Dark Souls 3. I'm a little bit wary about starting a game that is older than those games, even though it has been remastered, just because the mechanics and the actual like feel of the game has been substantially more refined since then. You know, Dark Souls 3 is a better game, I feel, than the old Demon's Souls, even though Demon's Souls had its own, you know, interesting ideas and whatnot. But, you know, did they take that into account when they did the remastering of it? Is it a new game? Or is it just like the same game, the same areas, the same like type of play styles, and not much else has changed? I'm kind of curious about that, because I think that it would be interesting if it had newer mechanics and newer ideas driving the development of Demon's Souls, the remaster, remake, whatever you want to call it. But then if they just, you know, revamped it and gave it new textures for the modern gaming revolution. I guess what I'm thinking of is, what kind of a remaster is it? Did they update the textures, or did they do the Resident Evil thing where they just like, they made it a completely new game, you know? And I guess even the remake of Resident Evil has a lot of similarities with the old games, but a lot of it is just like substantially new. New ideas and everything. What are we like waiting for here? Then again, I don't actually know that much about the Resident Evil 1 or 2 remake, let's be honest. Mantle Souls. Is there a lot of mantling in Demon's Souls? I don't remember. Maybe that explains why I couldn't ever figure out where to go. To be fair, like, the only thing I remember about Demon's Souls is things that I accidentally forget was actually Dark Souls 2. For some reason. I guess we're doing it like this, huh? It's... you're beautiful! Beautiful! Alright, let's try to op the next phase. I think we're at that point where the damage is good enough. Let's see what happens. Oh, my Guanstones are having a hard time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I did 1 damage. Oh god, I gotta work on that. And then we'll just go back to this, because this is fun. I don't know what's eating the bullets. Oh, the Guanstones haven't arrived yet! The Guanstones hadn't arrived and they were just breaking everything. You're beautiful.
Beautiful!
I can't see anything. I hope I'm hitting you, and I hope you're not hitting me. What a fun run. Awesome, amazing guns from the very beginning. It was very good. Thank you, Gungeon. That was a fun run. That's what I'm looking for. Everything is visually remade, but it's the same game. Shaders and S. Omnidirectional rolling. All the BS mechanics are the same. Okay. I assume that means that Demon's Soul still has its version of Blight Town, filled with, like, goo and spiders, if I remember correctly. Again, it's been a while since I played it, but I barely remember that much about it myself. Anyways, great run. For those of you on YouTube, thank you very much for watching. Like the video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe for more. Check me out on Twitch for when I go live. Support me on Twitch, Patreon, and Streamlabs, and I hope to see you here again for the next run of Enter the Gungeon.